Greetings. If you call yourself Muslim, you probably do so because you think it means you submit to the will of Allah. And I have produced videos that describe my respect for people who want to find and follow God. As harsh as I am on the lies Islam tells, I think you personally are sincere in your dedication to what you think is true. But I think those of you who follow Muhammad's religion have never given thought to the following. What if everything the Christians say and believe is true? What if Jesus really is the Son of God as he claimed? What if Jesus really was crucified on the cross as the prophets foretold? What if Jesus really did die on the cross as he claimed? What if Jesus really did rise from the dead, as the prophets foretold? What if Jesus did all the things and said all the things recorded in the true Injil? What if Christians are not exceeding their religion in any way? Then you are in a difficult predicament, my friend. If what the Christians say is true, you have chosen to follow a false path. But you can only understand what the Christians teach if you read the message of the prophets. And this is how Muhammad condemns you to blindness, brother. You say you believe the prophets. We also say we believe the prophets. The difference is we have the message of the prophets, but you do not have the message of the prophets. And that makes me wonder, how can you claim to respect a message you do not have? We know our God and we know His Word, and we know His plan was fulfilled by His Son. And we have the message of the prophets to prove the plan of God through time. And this is why any Christian who knows the Word of God will reject all claims of Islam. You, on the other hand, have only the words of one man alone, Muhammad. You do not have the message of the prophets.
No, 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 we have what Muhammad told us. Muhammad confirmed the message of the prophets.
Like I said, you have only the words of one man alone, Muhammad. You just admitted that.
No, 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 we have what Muhammad told us. Muhammad confirmed the message of the prophets.
By saying, I confirm that which came before me? I want you to think, brother. How does that confirm anything? Imagine I confirm every word spoken by the prophet of Noer. The Allah of Noer is the true Allah. The Allah of Noer sent Adam and Moses and Jesus and Muhammad. The Allah of Noer is the maker of heaven and earth. The Allah of Noer has 999 names. I confirm every word spoken by the prophet of Noer. Now, go find the prophet of Noer and learn what he said. But if you don't have the message of the prophet of Noer, you have no idea what he said. This is exactly the same as Muhammad confirming a book you are forced to claim does not exist. You believe that Moses was sent with the Torah, right? Well, so do we. And we prove it by including the Torah in the Bible. How come Islam does not respect the Torah enough to include it? I already know the lie you must claim to answer me, but it is easy to show it is a lie, brother, because Muhammad confirmed the Torah he held between his hands. So I ask again, submissive to Muhammad, how come Muhammad did not respect the Torah enough to include it? You say you believe that Jesus confirmed the Torah before him. Well, so do we. And the New Testament, the Injil that Jesus brought, makes many direct quotes from the Torah of Moses. How come the Quran does not include any text from the Torah or the Injil? If you claim to believe it, and you claim to respect it, and Muhammad claimed to confirm it, don't you think you should have it?
No, 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 we have what Muhammad gave us!
But that is the serious problem, brother. The people of the book, the Bible and the Torah, we have all the documents together. We have the message that all the prophets of God delivered. And because we have the whole message that all the prophets of God delivered, we can prove the plan of God. And I understand your claim that God's word was somehow changed. You must believe the word of God is changed. You must. You literally have no choice. You must believe the Torah and Bible are changed. You have no other alternative. Oh, actually, you do have an alternative, but you won't like it. You must allow yourself to question Muhammad. You must allow yourself to ask, Oh God, what if Muhammad was not a prophet as he alone claimed? I understand Muhammad claimed his words were true. I get that. I completely understand that Muhammad claimed his words were really a supernatural revelation. I also completely understand that logically, his claim cannot stand up to examination. That is why I have produced 8 videos that are irrefutable reasons to reject Islam. And my friend, not one has been answered by anyone who follows Muhammad. Not one person from Islam can stand up to the challenge. So I am asking myself, why can't Mohammedans answer these things? And there are only a few answers I can imagine. The first is that you have no interest in the truth, and therefore no respect for Almighty God. But I cannot accept that because I think you are sincere and you think you do follow Almighty God. Another is that you do not understand the questions in the videos. Your ability to hear and think has somehow been damaged by mindless repeating of meaningless syllables. But I think you can understand. Only you do not want to have to face the choice that facts and logic compel. The third is that you are deeply convinced to follow a web of lies, too strong for you to break. And that is the all too real possibility, given the Allah of Islam claims he is the best deceiver. So I am asking you who call yourself Muslim, the previous questions. Why do you not respect the message of the prophets even though you say you do? Why do you not include the Torah and the Injil in the Quran to show your respect? Why does the Quran not include any quotes from the Torah and Injil when the Bible includes both as proof of agreement? I look at these signs and they prove to me that Muhammad did not confirm the message of the prophets. I look at these signs and they prove to me that Muhammad changed the message and brought a different message. And that gets me back to the 3 possibilities, brother. Well, I stand before God and you today and declare, there is no God but Yahweh. And Yeshua is his son who died for you. If you are interested in honest discussion, free from lies and wrong assumptions, let me know. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.